I present our guest today. This is Réka Szabó, and the head of the dunaPart Budapest coordinator of the Sync Tones, I know, of course, dancer, choreographer and director. Beáta Barda is the executive director of Trafó, House of Contemporary Arts, and Eszter Kálmán is a set and costume designer, and she has her own project as well. My name is Tamás Jászay, I'm a critic, I'm an editor of Critic on the webpage, and I was one of the six curators of dunaPart for this year. First, I want a very short round with a very, not very simple question, but I want to know how and why did you get to the independent scene? And I think this set of answers will show why we chose you for this discussion, because I think you have very different background from very different roots you get into the independent scene. Rika?
My short answer to this question is I just fall in love with these movies. A bit longer than that time when I was young, the communist times. But do you hear me like this? Because I'm So in this communist time, there was no communist people know about this, but some people brought some information into Hungary from abroad about modern dance techniques. And I attended a university where I learned studying mathematics and informatics, but besides I attended this video dance class, and it's very intensive. And because there was no future for this art, and there was no example around me, it was clear that I was not a passion, it was just an art. And then after the changes, I looked, contemporary dance, for example, it was really a boom in Hungary. So a lot of people came to Hungary, also choreographing and so on. And quite soon I had I was chosen for an international dance project, and I started to do my own work. So slowly I went into this direction.
Yeah, and now you are the head of the symptoms, which is it's quite successful Hungarian dance ensemble, and you have to tour yourselves, because what would be something really between dance and theater, I suppose?
Yeah, I mean, I don't
mind
the rules when I'm
working
with this, the language of piece is always I'm interested in the theme, what I'm working with, and then we find slowly the tools how can we express the theme. So it can be movement, verbality, or visuality, or ability. So we have our pieces of theme, so we cannot say it because we have the same theme.
I think the case of Eszter is very special because she didn't start asking me why am I sitting at this table, because she calls herself a freelance second costume designer, but we all know, and Hungarians know it quite well, that you have your own projects from time to time with independent artists, with new artists, but your fixed background is design.
Yes, and as a designer, I also work on the same funding thing as well, so I've worked on the industry.
And you are both in international cooperations as well, right? Or you just work abroad for state theaters? And you are spent Schauspiel Haus in Nazi Kamera.
Yes, I've worked there.
Yeah, something like this. But you were from back to back to go as well.
Yes, and I also studied in the UK, so I'm coming from the international campus.
Okay, Beáta, when I asked my first question, how did you get involved in this? How did you get involved in independent scene? You put down your microphone, showing that no, you are not part of it. But we all know that you were the artistic director of Trafó for 10 years or 11 years, if I'm right. And from this season, you are the new executive director of Trafó. How did you get into this position? But, you know, this is my question. Hopefully.
Well, that's a very long story, because I'm not that
long.
But the thing is that I was interested in theater and dance from, let's say, from a very relatively young age, and then I started to do all kind of NGOs and stuff like that, finally getting into trouble for my life more than 10 years ago.
Okay. I know that you have a story together, and I'm sorry, hopefully it's not a secret story, but anyway, you'll be covering it up, because Beáta has a significant role in the thing that Eszter has prepared on Hungarian stages. I would like to hear this story because I think it shows the way how Trafó works. And later, of course, you had some comments to it. So what happened? How did you go here?
I'm answering this question? Yeah. Okay. So I moved home from the UK after university, and I had absolutely no connections or networking whatsoever. I knew nobody, really. So I thought that the only way I can work is if I make a performance in my own flat. With a friend of mine, so because I didn't know anybody, I was really touching email to all the press, to all newspapers I knew existed, asking them to please advertise this, and they all did. Great, they were really, really nice. So I guess there are still that effort and
on Facebook, yes,
and. And came to see the show to my flat, and it was only 14 people that could fit in. It was a very small studio, and
then I started to speak with each other. Yeah, as it was that.
Oh yeah, and that just had a big reaction.
And then, how difficult this way of starting your career, why do you think you have any experiences like this?
I guess that Trafó is not the place to start a career because it has 300 seats usually. But if you will see today that there is a small studio where there are 40 people or the club downstairs, which is relatively new, for 70. But we have to look around and try to find what's happening in the city, and luckily, or sometimes fortunately, but sometimes too much performances at the same time in the city. So what we are doing is trying to cover what's happening around us, trying to find people who are interested and moving in the direction we want to go. It's our mission, let's say.
What's the situation with dance?
Yeah, it will be, for us, it took a very long time. I think it's different in abroad, internationally, and here in Hungary. My first international success, I don't know, but as a young artist, I was invited to Aerobics. I problems when 19 years ago, I think, with a solo of mine, nobody knew me. So I had no connection, no, never in a group. And I was chosen. And I was so much surprised because in Hungary, things are went that time, like if you knew somebody, you have connections, you I don't know. That's the only chance. And it was, wow, I couldn't believe this. It's still touching this this feeling that you just based on your work, you get this possibility. And from that on, I started to get involved in international cinema. In Hungary, because I didn't, I have no diploma from dance, because there was no contemporary dance school that time when I was educated in Hungary. Though I had a very strong, had very strong base in gymnastics and so on, and lots of trainings, I didn't came from the. So who was who did faster career? They all came from either the. Official education, so from classical ballet, but then they did something else, or folk dance, because we have also high school for folk dance. Or they need a little bit of career in a group, then they came back. So then it was possible to take out a lot of money doing work. For me, it took, I don't know, 10, 12 years. And I think it's also because we got, in a way, what we are doing, I think it's really neat with the people, with the audience a lot of times. And so actually we got a lot of support from that side. Yeah, I would say that it was a very fast, long work.
I guess that the breakdowns road was quite difficult. She started as a solo artist, and then symptoms were from 15 years ago. Really 15 years ago.
Yeah. It's hard to say the exact beginning of the symptoms.
Yeah, okay. You mentioned the word suffered from the audience. A few years ago, and I know that many of our friends and friends of the Hungarian theater from abroad know a lot about the desperate situation of independence in Hungary, especially the case in 2012, if I am right, when the independents had to wait for the subsidy from the cultural ministry for 1.5 years. Am I right? Yes. Yeah, so more or less one year we had to wait. I'd like to hear some details about the present situation money-wise. So what happens when you want to create a new piece? And our speakers have very different perspectives on these very important questions. From my point of view as a critic or as a curator, I tell you what I said and I can say if I'm wrong or not, that in the case of Eszter, you have to apply for project grants, and in the case of Réka, with symptoms, you can apply for project grants as well, but you have an annual subsidy from the ministry, which you have to apply for year by year. And in the case of Trafó, it's also very special, and there is a very interesting change in the working methods of Trafó in the last few years. That Trafó, Trafó became one of the biggest producers or co-producers of contemporary Hungarian theater. So I would like to collect these
levels. Let's start with Trafó. Trafó is not an independent organization. Trafó is a theater of the municipality, as all the other theaters some ATV in Budapest. We get the same kind of support, the same method. We got a part of our funding from the ministry and a part of the funding from the city. Plus, there is another way, which is very dual theaters and all organizations, theater organizations. They can get support from enterprises who can support theaters, and then they get tax reduction. And we can receive this kind of support up to 80% of our net ticket income. So this means that ticket income is very important to all state theaters. They are working, everybody is working very hard to get more and more spectators, to get higher and higher ticket prices, to get more and more money. So it's a very strange system which encourages more popular performances with very famous actors.
You mean less experimental?
Less and less experimental. So we are going after the audience. Or most of the theaters want to serve the audience, the taste of the audience, because this is the easiest way to get money. So we have money from these practically these three sources, the ministry, the municipality, and this support from the enterprises. And we have this annual income, and then what we do is mostly co-produce Hungarian performances with the Hungarian independent groups. But we are never able or never want to give all the money they needed for a performance. We always ask them to have other resources like applying for funding from the National Cultural Fund or whatever. But we are trying to have as much as possible, but as they are getting less and less money from all kind of sources, then we have to give more and more. And it's not very happy or not very easy to find all the audience which a company needs for a performance.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, after a while we have to say that we cannot present the show because there are not enough spectators. So we have 300 seats and we have less and less spectators for a certain show. Then no matter what we think about the quality, after a certain moment we have to say that it's not for Trafó. We should move to another venue, but there are not much other venues, or there are smaller venues, not that well equipped technically.
Yeah, and just one more thing to put in the international context, the co-producing work of Trafó. Trafó is the only one in Hungary who co-produces the works of Hungarian Performing Arts. So you have.
So if they have an international co-production, it's always us, the Hungarian partner.
Okay, so what is the deal about money?
I have to apply as an individual, which I always do through Trafó. And so my roots are mainly in Trafó. And there's also another organization, which is called CRITIC, which I'm not sure what are they in English?
Independently together.
Independently together, which is like a...
So they are running the nanny incubator in house.
So most of the time we are in sort of co-production with them.
It's an umbrella organization having individual artists or independent groups to survive.
So even if not financially, but the organization side, so they have, so I'm just one person who
They had to move out
I don't know, 2 weeks or 3 weeks. And it meant that they had to, it happened 2.5 years ago, and they are now assistant, like, having the performances here or there in Budapest. So this, I think these examples, and you can touch what is the feeling to be an assistant, you never know. Money-wise, now it's a bit more than they reduced it in 2010. But now the election comes, you never know what will happen after, and they will want it, that's quite sure. And at the moment, the symptoms get quite the top annual funding, and it's 62,000 euros per year. We do 70 performances a year, and we have educational center, there's an educational program for teenagers, we have a lot of street actions, clubs, training, so we do a lot different activities besides having performances. So that's the situation. It's you don't feel at all that what you do is important for Hungary. It's such a good word, but it's to feel this. It's really after a while tiring. The other big problem is the project support. Because it was used also very much. At this time we get around 2,000 euros for creating a piece, which was much, much more 10 years ago. I had much more possibility than money. This forced us to make up all the time the collections with Trafó. We love to be in trouble, that's not a question. But this means that there is a big pressure on Trafó, because this is the only money we can give really money for a piece, creating a piece. So to go to a smaller piece, a smaller space, maybe to be, make more experimental work for a smaller audience, to really have this freedom, this is quite, we are losing this, and this is not a comfortable feeling.
Can I add something?
Yeah, sure.
The thing is that it's very, really very difficult for the companies or the individual artists to present their work, because, I mean, they have to present the work. They didn't get money for experimenting or for just trying all the things. It's only they have to have a premiere, at least one premiere a year, and a certain number of performances. That's how they get the support, the annual support. And Hungary is a very water-ready country. There's one big city, Budapest, and here they can perform. I mean, here, this is the only practically form of contemporary art, of Hungarian contemporary art, because otherwise, in the country, it's very difficult to sell the performances. So all the shows happen place are rather short, and a short time to leave those outside of the bench, expectantly, no place to present the work.
And there are some other problems that you already mentioned, but I won't emphasize it, but there are problems with the venues, because we have Trafó with 300 seats, or the club at Trafó with 80 or something, or the rehearsal with 40 seats, but we don't have many venues with, I don't know, 130 seats, or if we have like Skinny, where many of you have been before, or Move Theater, they don't have the same profile as Trafó. It's very, very difficult for them to invite audiences.
But they don't have the money.
And they don't have the money, of course.
Or Sorry? You are yet witness.
Yeah.
We are witness of the human causes in this country. But I think because now we are just complaining, and I would like to add some positive sides to it. That, finally, I think a big miracle happened to us also, Hungarian Incubator House. This is where the symptoms studio is located as well. And I think that it's fantastic that we have this incubator house. It's amazing. A lot of companies, studios are there, and it's in the city. It's a really nice feeling to be there, sharing, or the stuff we share there. So it's amazing that we have this. We don't know how long, but we have this. The other that I still do what I want to do. Of course, there are this much pressure, but I always have to remind myself that I still am free and I can do what I want to do in a way, in a country where there are really big problems, much bigger problems than our problems, and I feel still independent. With the project support, just one more sentence. That there is this a project as a company, and I can apply for two sources. Regularly, it's a national cultural fund, which was, when it was funded, it was an absolutely independent organization from politics. Now, it's not true anymore. And the other thing that this government gave a lot of permission for this Hungarian Academy of Arts. This is an organization which was a right-wing artistic organization, but they gave a lot of amazing lot of money to this organization, and they now became more and more powerful, and they also give money. So this is a decision that we don't apply to this organization, the symptoms. This big divide the independent area, because some of us are blind here, I can understand that. It's just for us, as far as I can do, I don't want to apply to this organization.
It's our money.
But I feel that if I apply, I make them legal. And I think they are illegal. And that's a question, you know, I don't know. I have no, I just have emotional answers.
Unfortunately, but I have this because many of my friends from abroad, they used to ask me many times that is there a censorship in Hungary? Or actually, they usually say that, oh, I read an article in New York Times or no one, I see that there is censorship in Hungary. I don't have anything to be sentenced. How do you think about it?
I don't feel that on the independent theater is any political censorship at all. The only pressure is, as I was saying, to fill out the auditorium, which is some sort of censorship in itself, to make a more popular work instead of what you find. I don't think maybe in the state funded theaters it's more questionable, I'm not sure, but I don't think it's.
Me neither, in a sense that when I create peace, it's not politicians never come to a performance and say this is impossible. But it happens that artists who articulate a very sharp opinion against she lived a really loud person, and also in many newspapers. That this annual subsidy was changed, for example, in his case. So the jury set a kind of amount of money for him, and then the minister came and said, no, it should be less. So this kind of things are happening, and also in the case of the theater director. So they're changing the theater directors. So that means not so much in the independent area, but in the case of the theaters, it happens very much that they change, and then the aesthetic change, the symptoms are changing. So a lot of.
Yeah, there is, of course. So what are the reasons? Because there is much bigger amount of state-funded theaters and municipality-funded theaters, I think. So there is, with independence, as I see, there is a sort of economic censorship. For example, the case of Schillen is very
obvious
or valid. Because, so we don't like what we do, we don't give you money.
Yes.
And what Esther mentioned, the self-censorship, I think it also exists, maybe not with independence, or I don't know if I can say an example right now, but in state theaters, yes, can be found.
And in our case, in countryside, there are almost no venues for contemporary art, so the only possibility to go to countryside, to go to theater, I mean, how do you say?
State theater, repertory theater.
But if there is a director who never invites you because he's at all not open for contemporary art.
And he doesn't know anything about independence, he never heard your name, so he won't invite you.
So now we feel this. Very much, if I don't invite any more to places than you were invited, also in the countryside. Because the reference for check was changed.
The thing is, we can reinforce this in every case, in our case, is to educate the audience. Because in the countryside, they practically no knowledge of contemporary art, and if the repertory theaters there, they only buy contemporary companies. But there's no way to let them know that there are other ways and other kind of aesthetics. So that's the most important thing. And there are quite a few independent companies working on having more and more people educating secondary school children and stuff like that.
Yeah, I want to the last question. Very nice, of course, or like some comments, but I want to hear a bit more about your audiences, because I think it's, so we were talking about it before, that it's still a problem to communicate with your audiences. You have some experiences in it, because you have dance teaching classes, or when you go to the provinces with some shows, that as a side program, there is a teaching class as well. But how can you, and of course this question is connected with communication, how can you reach your audiences? How can you, maybe it's not the best word, but how can you educate them? How can you invite them? How can you make them curious to your products? Because you are talking about producing is a must.
In the case of the symptoms, it's we cannot really complain because we try to have an audience in Budapest. There were a lot of times, yes, not we have the audience, but the pieces itself. Because we do quite different pieces, so actually we are starting how to connect with people's mind that it's the same company with this piece and that piece. I think we have troubles when we are doing more smaller and it's more experimental. Maybe we step over a kind of border. Yeah, but we still are working on to connect and slowly to in a way widen the audience eyes. And also in this, we do, as it's a little what we think, but it's very important that we go to schools. And we have a program with drama psychologist, teacher. So we collaborate with her and we have a program with running around for many, many years. And I think it's amazing. It's really important. Just what we do is just the drop in the sea.
What are your experiences with your parents and maybe this time to use the program in the
shop? Of course, I think we don't have an audience, we have several audiences because we do so much. So different things like music, theater, dance, new circuits, we have a class, we have a gallery. So it's, we work very much to always reach the, that specific audience you can meet with and produce something that in the Hungarian or international and we spend a lot of money and we always try to find new ways and more effective ways but it's difficult. And at the moment I just got a letter yesterday from the communication the head of communication of Trafó said that this November was the best in 20 years in numbers because there were so many people coming never before during the month, but it meant that we had more performances in all the three spaces we have than before. So it's always a struggle and we have to be very careful how we organize our program to have more popular shows or big shows like big companies from abroad or a new circus performance, which is always more popular. But it's really a hard work. And we spend a lot of money.
For me, it's very difficult. Because I'm not a company, I'm an independent person, and I'm also, I'm not a big name as for the public. So I mostly rely on Trafó to reach out to people who might be interested. I'm also relying on my name or the previous works I did that maybe if someone has that, that would be interested in the next one. So I have big difficulties communicating with my audience.
So it's your turn now. Any of you have any questions or comments for this discussion, please give you the microphone because there is a live stream for Hora.
Hi, I'm
Réka Szabó.
I'm an interviewer.
Yes, because now we stop. And networking starts soon here, so we can ask our participants.
There are so many performers and artists here, and there is a lot of guests, so we can be more.
Yeah.
It's been easier for me than it is for you.
Okay, and the networking stops at 12:30 because then you have to go and catch some shows. Okay, thank you for your participation.